All right, tonight I'm out at North Cascades National Park. It's gorgeous out here, a little smoky from forest fires, so hopefully that doesn't mess our plans up here. But I came out tonight because I wanted to get some Milky Way shots over a mountain called Liberty Mountain. It's been one I've been wanting to do for a while, and this was kind of an impromptu trip, but there's no moon tonight, no cloud cover. Again, hopefully the smoke doesn't mess that up. And it's really dark tonight, so hopefully it'll go well. I thought it might be fun if I bring you along for the ride, so let's see what we can find.
Man, look at those stars. It's so peaceful out here. Alone in the middle of the night. That doesn't sound creepy at all. It's unfortunately too dark for you to see the mountain on video, but just on a side note, so I'm shooting here on the A7S III. I'm at ISO 64,000. I'm curious to see how noisy this is in post. Now I've got a primary spot I want to shoot tonight and a secondary backup spot. This spot that I'm going to right now, it's a little harder to get to and I'm less sure about the terrain this time of year. But the, this is a little slippery. But the backup spot's a spot I've already been to and easier to get to. So who knows, maybe I'll hit that one too. But this spot I'm trying to hit, trying to find something that has some foreground elements. I mean, it's so dark out here. There's just nothing for foreground. So I'm hopeful I can, there's this little stream here. But you can see that, but it's in this field. Holy crap. I don't know if you can see that way back there. There's like 50 deer staring at me. You probably can't see it. My light's reflecting off their eyes. I'm gonna figure out how to get back there though, because it's all marshy. And I'm gonna figure it out and then I'll check back in here in a moment. Oh. Trying to stay in these deer trails so I don't disturb much vegetation. I feel like I'm making a Blair Witch Project movie. I think I'm gonna have to come scout this in the daytime sometime. This is just a maze and I'm like really close to the trees, so they're gonna block my shot of the mountain here anyway. I think I'm going to head back to my second spot and mark this down as a place I need to scout in the future. Second spot, here we come. All right, the other thing about the second spot is there's likely to be other photographers, but fingers crossed, haven't seen any cars up here yet, so nice. There's not a single car here, and it's definitely too hot for this jacket. It's gorgeous out here. Try a second time, see what we can find, and walk you through the images I take. All right, see you again. See you again in a minute.
It's like 11:35 right now. We're going that way.
Side note, the last time I came out to this spot, the snow was up to the bottom of this roof thing. So about 7.5-8 feet maybe. All right, again, sorry for the the found footage Blair Witch style of this video here, but I didn't bring a second tripod, so that's why I kind of wish I had now so I could put the video camera on something. But I'll just film it handhold here and start walking you through how I try to, you know, get a composition. For me tonight, the goal obviously is the Milky Way. So I'm not going to worry about the foreground. I mean, I care about the composition of the foreground because obviously if I get a good Milky Way shot, then I will care what the foreground in that shot looks like. But I'm not worried at the moment about exposing the foreground or anything like that. I'm worried first about getting a good Milky Way shot. Then I will go for a second set of exposures for the foreground. So give me a minute here. I'm going to set up and see what I can work out. It's a long way down. Over here, it's so far down that the light doesn't even hit the valley. It's just boosh. All right, see if you can see what I'm doing here. All right, so first to get my my composition, I'm just doing a very, short for night photography, 4 seconds here at f2.8. I have my ISO jacked way up, 128,000. Like, it will be totally unusable. But the reason I'm doing this is because I want to be able to see kind of quickly what my composition looks like so that I can determine, you know, how I need to line up, where I want to be, etc. So I'm going to take a peek. And yeah, you're not going to be able to see that screen, but I'm seeing here. So I got the Milky Way up over here. I got the road coming up out of this corner. Might actually move this just a tiny little bit and try again here. So I moved I pointed the camera a little further to the right and take another exposure. I'll even put these junk images up on the screen so you can hopefully see the process I'm going through. I'm gonna play this image back. And now I think I moved it too far. All right, so I got a composition I'm happy with. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go back and start to dial in the settings for the Milky Way. So my settings right now are 15 seconds, f2.8. I'm focused on the stars, and the way you would do that is you just jack your ISO way up. It'll be really noisy and grainy, but try to focus in on the star, and you just, you know, put your focus on manual and, you know, try to dial that in until the circle of the star gets as small as possible, and then you're essentially focused. And I'm going to, I think my ISO is a little low here, probably start off, I'm going to start off at 3200. I think that's probably going to be a little bit underexposed. But since I'm only at 15 seconds here, I can take a bunch of these exposures and really dial in kind of the combination of low noise and a bright enough exposure that I want. The reason I'm set at 15 seconds here, and this is just some of me knowing my gear. I'm on a 16 millimeter focal length right now. So if I were to follow the 500 rule, and essentially with the 500 rule, it's designed, and of course, every rule is meant to be broken. But what the 500 rule essentially is to help you not get star trails. Like there are some images where it's really cool, you get these really long star trails. But when you want pinpoint stars, you have to actually go with the shorter shutter speed because the stars are actually moving past you and the camera will pick that up. Now, I follow more of, there's a more precise rule called the NPF rule. And if you guys are interested, I can share the formulas for these. It definitely involves a little bit of math. The 500 rule is a little bit easier, but the NPF rule takes in the pixel shift for the size megapixel of your camera. So I just happen to know from shooting Milky Way before that if I go much above 20 seconds, I can start to see some star trails. So I'm going to try 15 seconds here at first, and we'll see what I get. I'll check back in with you guys once I get a composition, or once I get an exposure that I like. Let me see. Ooh, that looks really good. I might go with that. I mean, I'm definitely going to take more exposures, but I think that might be the one. So my final settings I ended up working on here were I ended up bumping up from 15 to 20 seconds, and I also bumped the ISO up to 4,000. So I think I should be okay with that. I might try to bump the ISO up just a little bit more, see how much I can tolerate. This will give me options in post. But essentially what that means, I'm sorry, I was having too many thoughts at once. But one thing I am definitely fighting here is the smoke. And if I start, increasing my exposure too much, I'm starting to pick up a little bit of that in the colors of the photo. So I'm trying to kind of get away with as low of exposure as I can to make sure I get nice, clean Milky Way to the extent possible. So I'm going to try a couple more exposures here. And then what we're going to do is I'm going to, sorry, I can't see my face. I guess I could try here. Got the head torch. Oof. It's like we're in a Ghosts movie. But I don't know if that's even worth it. But so essentially what I'm going to try to do now is I'm going to get a few more Milky Way exposures. And once I'm happy that I have a good enough selection, then I'm going to switch to exposing for the foreground. What I'll do then is then in post, when I process the photo, I'll blend the sky exposure, the clean sky exposure, with the clean foreground exposure. I don't use a star tracker, so I try to get two separate exposures, and then I'll do an exposure blend in post. So that's my process. I'm going to take a few more images here, and then I will show you how I expose for the foreground. All right, so what I'm doing right now is I'm trying to get a brighter exposure of the foreground. Like, I don't want the whole image to be dark and muddy, and if I try to kind of recover too many shadows from the sky exposure, then the shadows are going to be really noisy. So it's really dark out here. So I'm experimenting with some settings. You can see right here, I'm on ISO 1600 at the moment, f2.8, focused approximately to infinity here, and I'm on bulb mode. So what I'm doing is I'm just exposing. By the way, if you're a Sony user and you use the Imaging Edge mobile app, you can use the bulb mode without touching your camera by hooking it up via Wi-Fi. That's what I'm doing right now. So I'm running a 6-minute exposure at those settings here, and just timing it with my watch. And then what will happen, I have long exposure noise reduction turned on. So what will happen there is that it will take another 6-minute exposure, but with the shutter closed. So it'll be just a totally black exposure. And the camera's essentially trying to identify sensor noise. And then it will merge those two files together. So essentially canceling out the sensor noise for the main image. So that's what I'm doing right now. So it's a bit of a tedious process. I'm not going to make you sit here and walk through that, but I'm just showing you what I'm doing. If the exposure is still a little too dark, I might try this again, expose a little longer. I'm essentially trying to keep the ISO as low as possible because I want some really clean shadows. And essentially what I'm looking for is an exposure where the histogram is not completely buried on the left-hand side. So once I get an exposure I like, I'll show you on the back of the camera how I check that. All right, so it just finished processing. And if I punch in here, I can see I've got some pretty good detail in the shot. You can see the sky is all blown out, of course, because I exposed it for so long, and there's crazy star trails. But I think that's probably good enough for some foreground interest. But I think, and so let me show you here. I'm going to check my histogram. You see, I'm looking at my histograms here. Derp, turn it sideways. And I still have quite a bit of detail buried in the shadow, but see where these blinkies are happening here? It's all the way down the very bottom of the frame, where I don't really want interest to be drawn anyway, so I think I'm good with that. Yeah, but here's right here up here, you can see the histogram, you can see how much information. Oops, now I'm out of focus. You know, this is much harder to shoot in the pitch black than I would have thought anyway. Definitely need a second tripod or something, but anyway. So yeah, I think that's good. I'm gonna drive home now. I've got about a 3-hour drive, so, and I'll probably try to process these tomorrow or the day after. But if you're interested in seeing how I post-process this, let me know in the comments. I'll be happy to share that video. And otherwise, I'll see you in the next one. Make sure that you remember to, you know, do all the YouTube things. Subscribe, hit the bell, yada, yada. All right, see you guys next time. Later on.